Unfortunately, it didn't help the corruption fight. I respect the years that President Erap served, but I believe that GMA was way out of line and was doing it more for political expediency when she, in effect, washed away all the hard work of the anti-corruption advocates.
Now, do you think Senator Villar at some point will have to answer? I mean, because Erap has come out with, you know, certain accusations that
yes.
he was accused of himself.
Yes, and President Erap was spot on there. In fact, I'll soon be filing a plunder case against Senator Villar for a sweetheart deal he was involved in, which magnitude runs into the million.
Billions.
B.
Okay, what deal is this? This is not C5.
No, this is aside from C5. This has to do with the issue of land grabbing in North Sagaray. So that issue is very much alive, very valid, and Senator Villar has a lot to answer for in that issue.
Okay. Angelica Makalipay asks, aside from the reproductive health bill, what are your other priority programs? I think you've answered your priority programs. But regarding
Angelica.
The reproductive health bill, there's so much confusion that abortion is part of it.
Ah, it's totally not. And those with any intellectual honesty can just read the black and white of the bill, where it says nothing in this law amends the revised penal code under which abortion is a crime. So the RH bill does not legalize abortion. At kung totoong pro-life tayo, dapat pro-RH. The RH bill will prevent maternal deaths, will drastically, radically reduce the numbers, the crisis numbers.
Oh, nag-away daw kayo ni Kit Tata?
Hindi.
Sa harapan?
Hindi
walang
naman.
Yung debate ninyo?
Hindi naman.
Ultra-conservative yun eh.
Pero hindi ko siya aawayin kasi nakatatanda
only
siya
on
sa
issues.
Akin. Only on issues.
Issues.
And hindi rin naman niya ako inaway. Yung mga ideya namin, magkaaway. Pero kami bilang tao, hindi. Pero masaya ako na at least dun sa boto ng inyong mga tagapanood sa ABS-CBN at ANC.
70%. You were 70% trust rating.
Maraming salamat para doon. Or 80%.
Yeah.
If I
Do you think it's
correctly.
Your smile? No, I'm kidding.
I hope not only. If the smile doesn't hurt, well, salamat. But a smile wouldn't be enough. The viewers would have to like the idea.
Yes,
or it would have to resonate with their own beliefs.
No, what I want people to know is you didn't start off. You know, some of the very young voters may not remember you from who you were before.
Okay,
now let me say this. Riza Ontiveros, when I first moved to GMA 7 in 1993, Riza Ontiveros, you were married then
already.
You were married, but you were using Ontiveros.
Still.
She was the evening news anchor.
Yes,
it was GMA News.
That's right, GMA Network News.
News with
Leslie Espino, Mari Caimo, Vicky Morales. Hi, Vicky.
Yes.
And Marga Ortigas.
And you were known as one of the most articulate news anchors.
Salamat.
You know,
coming
you
from
were very pleasant on television. And you were very successful at your field. But my question is, why move from newscasting? Did you immediately go into politics?
No. It was, I am a founding member of Akabayan, but I didn't stand as a nominee till 2004. It was providential also. I left broadcasting simply because I turned 35 that year.
Okay.
Was co-anchor.
You left so young.
I did. But, you know, I was then with a show called XYZ Young Women's TV.
Okay. I remember that.
Oh, you remember that?
Yes.
Thank you.
Of course, I'm 100 years old.
No, you're younger than me, Uy.
Yeah, go ahead.
And I thought, okay, this is the most generous upper level of youth I know, the UN's definition, up to 35.
Yes.
Sabi ko, baka in my 40s and 50s, sobra pang enjoy ako dito sa Young Women's TV.
Sobra pa nag-enjoy.
Oo. So, pure fatalism. I left because it was time to leave, and I said, let's see whatever else comes along.
But
and this was it.
Politics where does this passion come from? This core
from youth.
Is it you were not born poor? I mean, I'm saying
well,
this only
I was
because
a middle class
of,
girl.
You know,
yeah,
I'm asking you this is because many people ask this. Oh. Given that Senator Manny Villar, when he sat here, said there's so many levels of poorness. There's poor,
my.
Very poor.
Well, by census categories, tama siya. But he was not poor. He was middle class. I was a middle class girl.
You were middle class.
Yeah,
but you went to a private school.
I went to a private school. I became a scholar there later. And in college, I was a scholar. Saints ko Manila din, Ateneo. Salamat sa kanila sa mga scholarships
na yun. Pero hindi ka naligo na sa basura?
Hindi. At saka wala naman akong pagnanais maligo sa dagat ng basura. Hello. Pero hindi rin siya totoong naligo sa dagat ng basura. That's been proven already.
Okay.
So I was a middle class girl. But martial law noon, Karen. So my first mass action was in the backyard, the garden of our house.
But where
Noise
did you
Baraj.
Live? He lived
in Merville Park.
I lived there too.
Oh, yun.
That's middle class. But he lived
tayo.
In Tondo.
Pero hindi sa Moriones, sa San Rafael, na rising middle class na nung panahong iyon.
Oh, this is very technical, ha?
Technical, pero accurate.
Is there somebody that censuses poorness in this country?
Yes, of course.
It's a very good study. Like, how can you say you're poor, average, middle class?
Right.
I mean, I'm not to hit on anybody, just technically to be
accurate.
Exactly, yeah. Because it seems to be a perception with different people. Because I can say, I have experienced poorness in our life when my father lost his job, you know, and we had nothing to go to school with. But maybe if you see me, you wouldn't say
that you had been poor.
Poor, exactly. Right. But I want to ask you that when you're middle class, but you didn't experience a sense of awakening when you were young.
But I did when I was a preteen at 12.
You did?
The noise barrage for Laban, then Ninoy Aquino campaigning from prison. Seryoso.
You were that young?
Old?
Oh my God.
No, you're noise barrage in it was called then Greater Manila area.
You were that socially aware at 12?
Well, my family was they voted, my parents and titos and titas voted for Marcos in 1965 thinking he was an alternative to the then corrupt President Macapagal.
Right.
Then by 1969 ayaw na nila sa kanya, nagiging obvious na yung corruption din ni Marcos noon.
Uh-oh.
Yung human rights violations dumadami na o nalalaman na ng tao.
Uh-oh.
They did not vote for him in 69. And after martial law in 72, ayan, we experienced the curfews, naririnig na namin yung tumitinding korupsyon, human rights violations. Natakot na sila at nagalit kay Marcos.
Okay, so those watching right now that may not be aware, unless I don't know what planet you're from, she is also the sister of Pia Ontivero.
Yes.
Our colleague who's a tough cookie and asking questions. Yes. But more than that, Are you close? Are you alive? Are you very close?
We're close. We are the closest in age. I'm only 1 year younger. I mean, older.
All right. Okay.
Older than her.
Yeah. And who's tougher between you?
Of course, Pia.
Okay.
Internally, same raw material.
Same raw material. All right. And you don't want to go back? I mean, Pia's still on television?
No. Well, if I were to go back to anything more than broadcasting, it would be theater and music. Yun talaga yung.
But do you and Pia ever fight on issues?
Of course. We're two individuals with very strong opinions.
So do you stand up during Sunday lunch already? What happens?
Hindi naman. Ano lang, friendly debate.
Politics can wreck families sometimes, huh?
I know.
It's terrible how debates in our family are awful.
Talaga.
We throw plates.
Oh my gosh.
No, I'm kidding.
Sayang yung plato. Hindi ko ginagawa.
I'm kidding. I make people laugh on the show.
Yeah.
All right, Alcide asks, as a proponent of the RH bill, this is a good question. Will you support the legalization of prostitution?
Ah, no. Thanks, Alcid, for that question. Kasi yung mga kasama namin, katrabaho namin, prostitution survivors, who drafted our anti-prostitution bill, well, nire-respeto nila yung sa ibang bansa, prostituted women, treat prostitution as work. So they're working for health benefits, labor rights as working prostituted women. Mm-hmm. Pero dito sa Pilipinas, ang prostitution survivors, iba ang track nila. They don't see it as decent work for them and their not decent in moral terms, but deeper in humanistic terms.
Because in Europe, we have to say some countries it is legal.
The Netherlands and some others, for
they're
example.
They're moral about it. It's not an issue to them.
It's a human rights issue to them. It's a labor issue. Here, ang rights-based perspective ng mga prostituted women, the bill says remove the criminal liability from prostituted women, transfer it to those really benefiting from the industry, like the pimps, the establishment owners, the customers themselves, and yung mga tiwaling police.